Yeah, just really excited for them. Those two have, I think, earned it. They've worked hard. They put in the time, and that's as a result of playing on a team that they've been able to thrive with. And I'm really proud of them. Really, very proud of them.
You played so well in Duluth last year. How do you guys go about recapturing the way you played down there?
You know, Dan, I think it's about we take one game at a time and who we're playing, and we really focus on the end result. Our goal is to win the tournament. So I think it's how we present it as coaches and how our kids will respond. But, they're pretty focused on wanting to win the regular season and win the tournament. So I think they understand it's going to be a battle. Anybody that goes through 5, 4, 3 grueling that games, it's tough. So I think they understand we got to have focus, no distractions, and keep one game at a time.
Do you have to coach a little bit differently when you're trying to look at playing 3 games in 3 days, or you just, or does
yeah,
nothing change?
You do, just to a point where you get in a game where you can be a little mindful of, okay, can I give this person a rest, and can this person get us minutes that normally don't, because it'd be really hard for our starting five to play in the upper 30s, 40 minutes. I think it's just, it's too demanding on how we want to play. Now, we may not run as much, but you got to go with what got you there. So you got to do it until you feel comfortable enough with if you want to change.
It's been a few years since you guys have, the tournament's been in Little Rock. Just any thoughts on going back to Arkansas?
Yeah. With this event? Well, I think they go back because I think the community supports it, and Missouri's playing real well, so I think that Arkansas's playing well. They're close by, and we're there. We'll draw the Memphis crowd, so I think just because of the support, and they want to give people different opportunities to see the SEC tournament.
The men have locked into Nashville for a while. Would you like to be locked
in? I'd love
one?
To. Yeah. I'd loved us to lock into Nashville, but that didn't happen. So I think we're looking for a permanent spot, and I think it has to be real strategic where fans can get to very easily.
What would you like to see?
We talked in our meetings about Chattanooga. They're going to have to redo the facility for there. Atlanta, it's centrally located. I think they're looking at just all different places. But I think it's really positive where fans will know this is where the SEC is. And every year we're going to stay in this hotel and we're going to do this and kind of get a little pattern down of what they do, and they're familiar with it. Just like I think the Women's Softball World Series is in one spot, and I think it's a great idea.
Pretty familiar with Georgia by now, but you haven't played Missouri in quite a while. How different a team are they now versus maybe when you first played? It's like they've come on strong.
Well, Missouri gave us a heck of a game here, so I know how they play. I know their coach. I know their style, and at times it's given us fits with them spreading the floor out, shooting the three, and can penetrate. So we're more prepared to play Missouri, but I'm sure I haven't looked at them a whole lot, but I'm sure that she feels obviously they've gotten better in some areas. So more familiar with Georgia because we played them twice and we just got through playing them. But we'll get re-familiar with Missouri as well.
How do you go about practice this week, not knowing which one of those you'll see on?
Well, you just work on your – you work on you. We work on our weaknesses. We're going to work a lot on rebounding offensively and defensively, trying to take care of the ball, going against a lot of pressure with the guys pressing us and attacking us. And then we're going to work on our presses and just everything, our persistence drill to make sure that your back's against the wall. How are we going to react? How are we going to respond? So we'll work on us next couple of days.
Did Izzy have a surgery today?
Can I comment on that? I cannot comment on that. So
Jordan was. Oh, were you about to say something?
No.
Jordan was saying that Ariel's performance in the last game maybe just a kickstart of what she's capable of doing in the tournament. Is that something that you could see him maybe her scoring about 18 a game.
I love it. I love it. I think Ariel's playing a lot more relaxed, a lot more, not that she wasn't in tune, but she's very focused, being a great leader for this team. And I think she's having fun. She's enjoying what she's doing, and she's been successful doing it. I do want to say this. I know that things came out with the SEC. Very, very disappointed that Andrea Carter didn't get on the defensive team. I know how hard she works, and I know how good she is defensively, and I think she's the best. You know, I think she's one of the best in the conference, and it doesn't equate just to steals. It just equates to what she does to the player she's guarding, and so disappointed she didn't get it, but I'm probably positive that she'll continue to work hard and get better.
Could be a little motivation, you know, going to
Absolutely.
Arkansas. You know?
Absolutely. I haven't even talked to her, but that's my thoughts, but it is what it is. It's not all about awards, and she'll tell you that. But I know how hard she works on that end, and I'm a little biased to that end because a lot of that doesn't show up in the box scores and those type of things. So she's a heck of a defender.
Is this the most confident you've been in any of your team's years' ability to make a deep NCAA tournament run?
Yeah, I think it's one of the best teams that we've had to think that we can make a deep run. Absolutely. Now, would I feel, with Izzy out and how we've progressed? I like it. I like how we're playing as a team, how we're moving the ball. We're committed to the defensive end. Yeah, I think this is we're really clicking on all cylinders right now.
Holly, with not having Izzy in mind, going into this event, what's the one thing you're still maybe? Well, we got to really lock it down a little bit more on that aspect of our play.
I just think depth, Dan. I think depth on how we can play three games for 40. Certain people can play a lot of minutes, and we got to get minutes off our bench. So we got to have Nia step up. We got to have Courtney, Jamie, Alexa. They got to step up, and. We're gonna need some minutes for them.
So you anticipate playing nine people?
I'd like to. If how I'd like for it to go, I would love to. But it depends on how we're playing and how we're responding and what the score is and all that, those kind of factors.
How much confidence does last year's tournament, just coming back from three deficits and both all three of those games, give this team?
I think we've done a great job this year of being down and outside of really Texas that we were really horrible. I think we've done a great job of fighting back and coming back when we've been behind. So I don't think they think of they're ever out of a game, which I love. And so I think last year it played to our favor. And I would really like to just get up and stay up, if you want to know the truth. So that makes for a better coach's nerves than always playing from behind.